And that's it. And there you go. That's the end of Life is Strange. There is no other games. There's no other books. No comics. No... Son of a bitch! Oh, for fuck's sake. I'm done. Nope. Not even at the computer. I got up. I'm at the other side of the room. Which is about 2 feet from the computer. I don't know what to say. I was going to say, how about this is the end? There was no other game. That was a dream. But they had to go and throw that in because the developers are assholes. That's why. Thanks a lot, guys. Really doing a great service. Well, the bonus episode. Whoop-de-doo. Great. More. Farewell episode, which will be available in the deluxe edition, but I'm assuming it's not ready yet, because it's not here. Let's go into collector mode and see if I missed anything. I missed something in upstairs, Price's house. Otherwise, it looks like... Oh, I missed something at the old mill as well, apparently. Curious. I really tried searching around that area. So we missed two of them. We'll go ahead and do that, but I need to sit back and we need to talk about Hell is Empty, because I didn't get a chance to really talk about it. We need to just talk about the game in general, because again, I didn't get a chance to talk about it. So I think this is not going to be marked. I'll just mark this as the final episode of the episode, because technically we're still talking about it. Life is Strange Before the Storm, excluding the bonus episode, was an experience. Never before have I felt this way towards a video game. Never before have I felt this way towards a game so well written that it isn't a game, it's a movie. It's a story, it's a book that moves. I thought this same thing when I played Life is Strange, and while I might have had some teary-eyed moments in this game, the only thing that still worries me is the fact about how this is going to affect my experience with Life is Strange. Because now that we know more about Chloe and Rachel's relationship, we know how close they were, we know their personalities more, moving into Life is Strange, you're going to be looking at things a lot differently now. Because I said I was going to play through Life is Strange again after I finish this game. And that's what I'm going to do. And I don't look forward to it, because now it's going to affect me even more because of that. And that's just depressing. That's just hella depressing, okay? I went there. But I think the real charm is the writing about these. There has never been another choice-based game that I've played that's been anything like this. And I don't think there's going to be any game like this for years, decades even. Unless there's another Life is Strange. And there is. There's Life is Strange 2. Apparently going to be worked on, or is being worked on right now. A lot of people think Before the Storm is Life is Strange 2. But Life is Strange 2 is actually a different Life is Strange. According to what I've read so far, it's supposed to be based on a different set of characters. So, yeah. I'm not sure if I can accept that or not, because I've grown on these characters so much already. It's going to be really hard for me to get used to new people, but if it's anything like this, I'm pretty sure I'll get attached. I really wish I could just end it with this game. I really do. The writing is, it's amazing. This is a movie. This is, you sit down, you sit back, you watch, you move a little bit, you talk to people, and you see what happens. The acting, the voice acting is some of the best, in my opinion, especially in the areas where the characters need to be serious or sad and depressed. And those were the areas that hurt me the most in this game, when I saw characters in distress. I am a little sad that I failed that backtalk with Fucker. I realize now that Hurry Up was obviously the wrong choice, the only wrong choice. And that's because I was under pressure and the time was dropping so quick. And I hit something, hoping that it would work. And I failed it. It was the very last one in the game, and it was the one I missed, because I'm a dumbass. Sucks, almost had a clean sweep on the game there, but I kind of want to go back in and experience that part again just to see what would have happened. Like, I'm sure the cops would have showed up or something like that, and he would have been busted and we would have gotten out of there. I don't know. Or either that, or the cops would have shown up and he would have taken off running, and that would have given us our time to escape. I was not expecting anything to happen to Rachel in this. I mean, I've played Life is Strange. I know what happens. I don't want to talk too much about it in case you have not played that game or seen it. But I guess I'll give you a spoiler warning. A big spoiler warning here for Life is Strange. So this is your time to turn away if you don't want to know any more about the story. Well, in Life is Strange, you basically spend a good portion of your time helping Chloe, playing as Max, obviously, figure out what happened to Rachel, as she had been missing for like 6 months or something like that. And you find out she's dead. How much more I can say than that? And the reaction Chloe gives is so heartbreaking. But it's going to be even worse now. Now that I've seen their relationship and know who Rachel is, it's going to be a whole different experience when I go to play through that game again. Maybe I should just record myself playing it again. Not upload it, but just in case I have another terrible reaction like I did my first time around. I don't know if people... I'm sure a lot of the people that are actually watching this right now have seen my original Life is Strange LP. And I did pretty okay through a majority of it, except for maybe two places where I basically broke down. Especially the one that was at the very end. I never thought Chloe would ever make me feel that way. I didn't really like Chloe as a character throughout Life is Strange. But she did. Somehow she did. When the ending of the game came around, I chose to sacrifice Chloe because I thought it was the right choice to make. And the effect it had on me was horrible. I'm thinking back to it now, and it's the cues. It's the cues that always get me. There are certain things that make me feel emotional more so than usual. Especially, you know, you give me a character that I'm attached to, or get attached to, and kill her off, or kill them off, whoever. Of course I'm going to be sad and depressed and probably cry a little bit. That's to be expected. But there's certain cues that will make me feel even more emotionally unstable. Number one is music. If the right music plays and kicks in, which Life is Strange seems to do perfectly well, it's going to, for some reason, enhance the amount at my feeling. I don't know why, it just happens. Two is seeing other people's reactions to it. Not real people, obviously, in the story. Max's reaction to everything, when she had to let Chloe get killed. That's terrible. And that was one other reason why I broke down so fast and so hard. And then that's also why in this game, seeing Chloe's reaction to finding her dad's car and thinking about it. You know, seeing her reaction to just anything. When one of these characters screams, instantly, tears, instantly. And I'm not kidding. This is why people want me to get a webcam, so they can see this shit. I don't want them to see this shit. That's why I don't have a webcam, because I don't have the money for one. But I would rather you not see that shit, because it's embarrassing. But apparently everyone else that I've ever talked to has had similar experiences with games like this, so I would like to say that I am not in the minority on that. I'm currently twisting scissors around my finger right now. It really sucks that it's come to an end, because this is now officially an end, as far as I'm aware, to this storyline. Now it's just up to people to make their own stories. You know, when you're... Let's be honest, when you're in denial, you like to say, oh yeah, well, Chloe and Rachel are still alive. It was all bullshit. It was a mistake. Uh-huh. That's called denial. That's called you don't want to accept it. Maybe you know it, maybe you don't. But as much as I wish these two, you know, move on, travel across the world, and live together happily ever after, they're both dead. So, there you go. Thanks a lot, Life is Strange. Thanks. You made me feel great. Well, I guess there's really not much else to say that I haven't already said before. That's how I feel about Life is Strange. Life is Strange did a lot for me, since this won't technically be the last episode, but this is the end. This is the story end. So I just want to thank Life is Strange for a few things. Number one, I want to congratulate the creators of this story, the writers, the developers, everything, for crafting such a beautiful project that has become so popular, and rightfully so. And I hope that they continue to work on stuff like this in the future, so that we can experience more of it. Life is Strange, when I'm playing it, it feels real. I think that's why I'm able to connect with it so much. It's hard for me to get emotional with something if it doesn't feel real. If you give me, you know, a TV show that is based somewhat in reality, it'll make me feel. Shows like The Walking Dead or Breaking Bad, I will feel for those shows because they are based and set in reality, and they make sense, and they are realistic. Life is Strange falls in that same category. If you give me something that is over the top, or a comedy, or something that is not believable, and you kill a character off, and you make it all sad and depressing, it's not going to make me feel probably at all. Because I cannot connect with it, I cannot relate to it. I can relate to Life is Strange. Especially a lot of the stuff in the game, not the sad, depressing stuff, but a lot of the normal stuff, because these kids, they're just kids out of high school. In high school in this game, out of high school in the next game, I believe. Okay, or about to be out, I guess I should say. That's my age. 19 is how old I am at the time of recording this, and I was 18 at the time of recording Life is Strange. In fact, no, I wasn't. I was 17 when I recorded Life is Strange, the first one. So, yeah, it's 2 years? It hasn't been 2 years yet. It has! Or no, it hasn't. It'll be 2 years in early 2018 is when it'll hit the two-year mark. Because I had recorded Life is Strange somewhere in early to mid-2016, and my birthday is on September 2nd. So obviously I had recorded the game before my birthday rolled around. I'm that age. Okay, I can relate to these kids, these characters. I can relate to their feelings, what their interests. And that's, I think, why it's so much more realistic to me. And that's why the game feels real. Not to mention the great voice acting. You know, you can't make it feel real if you've got fake and boring or crap. And I'm surprised, you know, that I was able to enjoy something like this, and it was able to affect me. That should just go to show that these types of games, I don't have a set preference of games. I will play anything, and I will enjoy and experience anything. You know, whether it be a first-person shooter, a role-playing game, a real-time strategy, or whatever you consider this. I guess I would consider this like a choice-based story game, or something like that, choices matter game. Because that's it. There is no gameplay, per se. You walk around a little bit, look at things, and talk to people. But it's the talking that matters. It's the just the writing, the story. That's the most important thing. And it works. I want to play more of these. I really do. I don't think I've actually done any other choices games on my channel before. I really think Life is Strange and Before the Storm are the only two Choices Matter games that I've ever played. On the channel, at least. That is crazy. Maybe we need to change that. But that's going to bring this to an end. I'm going to go ahead and do my usual where I record and get the last pieces of graffiti. Feel free to post your comments on whatever the hell you want to in the comments below. Just tell me whatever. And I guess the only remaining videos I have to do on Before the Storm are the bonus episode. And I think I'm only going to do one video on the bonus episode. If it's longer than 35 minutes, I will record it for longer than 35 minutes. Okay? And I'll just upload one whole episode of it, which will be the final Life is Strange video for right now until the sequel or something comes out. So, thank you so much for sticking along and watching. And I hope to see you again soon, whenever that may be. But these videos will always exist. And someday, in 20 years, if I'm still alive, I can look back, hopefully when I'm not shit, I can look back on all of this and say, wow. You know, now that we're on Life is Strange 8, I'm surprised that this made me feel so much. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.